Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Duo here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to My Hero Academia Season 3, Episode 12. Episode 50 in total, and this one's titled End of the Beginning, Beginning of the End. I should have done that with the opposite hands because that only really makes sense for me in the way the camera flips. Anyway, after All Might and All for One's fight, the students go back home while the UA teachers decide how to deal with the aftermath. Now, this, if I remember correctly, the aftermath of this fight leads into a sort of lull in terms of action, so expect some more, like, character building or world-building episodes, not... We're still on this one. I honestly thought we'd have gone on to the next one. It does make sense though. 12 episodes on this, 12 episodes on the next one, because I'm pretty sure there's 24 episodes in this season. Yeah, 39 to 63 is 24. Oh well. It'll be interesting to see what the next opening is. Because we've now seen everything that this opening alludes to. I got my other Harry Potter mug. It's a color-changing one that may have gone through the dishwasher a couple times, so it's more of a dull color now. Yeah, but you got the symbol of evil. It's through the power of joint experiences, group learning. weird to see him out of uniform. It's understandable. Get rid of all attachments so they can't be used against you. Especially in the mindset of your husband having been killed for that exact reason. I mean, yes, I'm physically alive, but do you think the kids were caught on camera? 'Cause there was that news helicopter circling around. He is very much to All Might as Bakugo is to, I'd say, Todoroki. With the whole wanting to surpass them and getting pissed when doesn't accept surpassing All Might the way he did, just like Bakugo didn't accept winning the thingo against Todoroki. Realistically, that would have fallen out of your hand. I wonder if he ever just, like, launches off the balcony to get down instead of taking the flights of stairs. That reminds me of Madagascar. Well, I didn't get out of it uninjured, 'cause you injured me because of it. three retired heroes now. Well. I don't know if the other two are would be retired because of this. Correction, I know the exact status of both of them, but could be retired, could be fully active as heroes again. be weird to walk into a house and just see your face everywhere. Never did tell his mom. I do like how a lot of that was written in hiragana, because, well, that's the first and easiest language of the Japanese language, and it makes sense that that's the one Coda would know how to write in. Also means I can read it. Can't understand it, but I can read it. you don't get to die protecting him. You have to live to protect him always. And I guess that's the official end to the arc, I think. I'm not sure if the next series of events counts as that arc. I guess we'll see from the opening, but it is funny that, well, two of the three students who got the worst of the villain attack on the training for us, so Jiro, Toru, and Bakugo, two of their parents were completely fine with the UA dorm system. We don't know about Toru's parents, but yeah, like, Jiro's parents seemed just like, okay, I have full faith in all these teachers, despite their misgivings. Bakugo's mom's just like, I know how my son was raised. I know it wasn't the best. But you are the ones most capable of leading him down a proper path. I do like the fact that they showed him holding three separate hands with his fingers so that he wasn't actually touching a single hand with all five. But as I was saying, Mitsuki and I forget his Bakugo's dad's name, they believe that Aizawa and All Might and that are the best chance for their son. Mika and it starts with Kyo, I don't know his name either, and well, they're just like, heroes are the best people to keep our daughter safe when training to become a hero. And you've both risked your life countless times already in that effort, so you're well and good to do it again. And then you've got Inko, who is the other side of the realistic parent, where her worry in that, she put the correlation that if he wasn't there, he wouldn't be attacked. If he wants to be a hero, he can go to a different school, which at this point wouldn't work because he's on the villain's radar. But I can understand how a worried parent would believe it to be localized with UA and All Might, not partially, they're seeking out Izuku as well. And, well, likely it would have led to them coming after a different school, but it is understandable. And that's what I really like about this show. A lot of the decisions, they aren't just done in blind faith. Like, all their decisions are based off of intelligent analysis of events, which you don't really see in a lot of I'm going to say cartoon because I want to group this in with American cartoons, so I'm just going to say animated shows, where it's either the parents are just like, I have no problem with this, despite there being very large and glaring problems with any decision made, or there's no decision from the parents at all. It's just the teenager and or kids just doing whatever they want. Here you've actually got realistic depictions of various different types of parents that I've actually seen in real life, because Inko reminds me of my own mother. Mitski reminds me of my mate's mum. And the relationship between her and my mate is pretty much, well, sort of the same as between Bakugo and Katsuki and Mitsuki. I can't pronounce her name. And yeah, it's nice to see in a world where pretty much anything is possible, there's still realism in that. That's the end to my just sort of deep dive into nothingness, so I'll catch you in the next episode.